All right, everybody, welcome to the studio this evening. And look, my mic is working. First thing right out of the box. I hate when it doesn't work. I hope everyone is doing well this evening. I'm excited to paint what I've got here. You can see the background image that I have over there is this place near where I live, a couple of miles away, called Hollister Peak. It's a beautiful mountain. I pass it every day on the way to work. And I look over there and I go, man, I should paint that. I should paint that all the time. I've done a few quick little paintings of it. I should paint that. And I rarely ever do so. Today, that's going to be the backdrop for my painting. I've put in the front a barn, and a fence, and this will all come to life. I didn't have one great picture of Hollister with a farm in front or anything like that, so I've kind of cheated. You'll see it develop as we go along. Got a few people here. Thirsty for a Brew is here. Lab Accident. Dwayne Wilcox, the Crafty Visage, is here. Carrie Hall is here. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining me. Let's see. A few things to get started with. Over here in the lower right-hand corner, I am still using the studio palette that I've used here for a long time. It's M. Graham watercolor paints. I don't know how many of them there are. I'm happy to go through these and tell you exactly what I have on my palette and why, if you guys want to hear about that. For the most part, I'm going to be using my KingArt brushes again. I'm actually, because I'm painting the sky, excuse me, and I can do a lot more with a quill brush, holds a ton of water. These are my Dana quill brushes. They are not overly expensive, but I think they're quite worth the money for what you get out of these. Jacqueline Rivera is here. Welcome, Jacqueline. The paper that I'm using is Strathmore 400 series watercolor paper. I still have some left from that big chunk of paper that I had, from that big block of paper that I had. I'm still using it, whittling it down a little at a time. I'm just going to mix a puddle here. I've got some white paint in here somehow. Let's get that out of there. Get some hardened gouache in there. I'm just going to mix up a little bit of this cerulean blue I'm going to use as my sky. I'm gonna make it very light. If you look at the reference photo there, no clouds, not a lot of deep blue, not much of anything. I've said it before, that's what my skies look like here where I live. We don't have a whole lot of cloudy days. We don't have deep blue skies. We've got some very light clouds at best. We do get quite a bit of fog where I live, not necessarily here where this rock is at, where this mountain is at. But we do get a little bit of that. So I'm just gonna have a watery mix here and I'm just gonna pull it down. It's gonna be very light. While I'm doing this, I want to encourage anybody, if you have any questions, to please throw them out there. Say this every week and I'll continue to say it because it's part of what makes doing this live stream an enjoyable experience, for me certainly, and I think for you all. I mean, and I certainly hope you want to do more than just sit at your phone or your computer or your tablet or wherever you're watching this, however you're watching this, and listen to me prattle on for an hour or an hour and a half or however long I happen to go on about this. So if you've got questions, please, please, please throw them out there. I love to answer them. So this is fairly wet, and my table is at an angle of probably, I don't know, not more than 5, maybe 7 degrees, not a whole lot, but just enough. You can see that the water is going to run down on here just a little bit and form a little ribbon of water here. I'm just gonna pull that off. Not a big deal. If you were so indisposed, you could go back and add a little bit more color. I would do it this way. You could add a little bit more color up here to the top just make this color a little bit richer at the top. And of course, while it's still wet, we can do just about anything to this that we want. It's once it starts to dry out that we really have to be careful with it. We can just pull that color right on down. And if it's not exactly perfect, it's not exactly perfect. You can always go back in. As long as it's wet, we can do a lot with this, but that's about what I want. I've got just a little bit more here. I'm just going to pull this off. If I don't pull this off, it's going to turn into a little bit of a back run. And then while I'm waiting for that, I'm going to come and do this. Let's see. I'm going to paint my barn here. And it's going to be kind of a rusty brown red color. Right? Maybe it started off as a bright red and it's got a lot of dirt and dust on it here. And it's old, it's faded, it's not real. It's not really red anymore. It's kind of an off color of red. So I'm going to drop some of this color on there. I'm just trying to follow that roof line. Let's see, that's the door that goes over. Shoot, I'll paint the door too. We can do that. There's a little tree right here that I want to kind of not paint on. And I want to do this so you guys can see. There's a little bush back here too. So you guys can see the basic shape of this building because I don't have it in the reference photo. So you've got to be able to imagine it as I'm painting it. Okay, so there's my barn. Right there is just setting right there. I've got the hillside up here, the mountains up here. I should say, I'll give you a little history lesson, if you want me to, while I'm here. This feature, this mountain here, is actually one of seven different mountains like this where I live. And kind of the cool thing is that the Pacific Plate, which has been moving steadily over the millennia, centuries and whatnot, moving a little at a time, a little at a time. What has happened is each of these used to be the cap over where a volcano was. So the volcano used to sit right underneath this. And the plate has moved, the rock has moved, and the volcano is still here. And the volcano is actually miles out into the ocean. Probably, if I had to guess, I would say the actual volcano is probably 8 or 9 miles, maybe 10 to a dozen miles away from this mountain right here. But the land has just moved across the top of it. So it's kind of a cool thing. Kind of a cool thing. Like I said, there are seven of them. We call them the Seven Sisters. They all have a different name, and they all are about, I don't know, 2, 3, 4 miles apart. That is kind of a little bit of history there. Kind of a neat little thing. Yes, I'm waiting for my sky to dry. So if you've got any questions, now is a great time to throw them out. If there are no questions, wait. Don Wilcox says, hello, I'm so glad I keep catching you live. I'm glad you catch me live too, Don. I'm glad one of you guys make it. I do want to share this, while I'm waiting for this to dry. This is what I worked on, last week. I shared this in Discord. I kind of had fun painting this. It's got some real detail up here in the feathers. His eye kind of came out a little triangular there. Not so happy about that, but I love the look of the feathers down here and the different colors, the greens and the blues and the reds inside the black there. I love that because when you look at a bird, they typically do look like that. They have that iridescence to them that I really like. I've got a couple other things I want to show you. This just fell. I finished this up. I need to post this video. But if you remember, I was going to do a review. Look at how this shimmers. I was going to do a review of these Super Vision colors. Well, this is my swatch of those colors, and it's mica infused watercolor paints. You can see, like, it's really got a lot of shimmer and shine on there. So that's really cool. I've got that coming up. And is that it? Maybe that's it. Maybe that's all I had for you. Are we dry yet? We're pretty close. I think we're good enough. Okay, so I'm going to jump back into the painting. And I've got in this picture, in my mind, this is what I'm envisioning. The light is coming from the top corner here down this way. Or actually, I guess it's just going across. So that means everything on this half of the rocks is going to be the shadow side. Everything on this side is going to be in light. So the roof here will be in light. There will be a shadow here. This rock will cast a shadow over here. This big rock will cast a shadow over here. Let's see. Jacqueline says, are they light fast? Those supervision colors, they're somewhat light fast. Somewhat, not super light fast. I'm not. I talk about it a little bit in my review. I wish they were a little higher quality, but they're kind of cool. Don Wilcox, you just follow me on. You just follow my Discord. Thank you. I hope you get in there. If you have questions, please ask questions in there. If you want to post some artwork, you want some people to take a look at it and give you a review of it, I'll give you a review of what. A nice positive review. I'm not into telling you how bad anything is. If it's bad, it's never bad. There's always good. There's always, always good. But I'm happy to share my opinions on something and talk about whatever you want to on there. Like I said, I post my stuff on there. There are challenges on there. There's one coming up due here. I need to finish mine up. Margaret is here. Welcome, Margaret. Welcome back, I should say. Welcome back. I'm just trying to mix up a little bit of green here. I love my phthalo green, so I'm going to put some of that in. And I don't know how I'm mixing this, really. Obviously, I'm looking for a certain color in this. So I think I've got enough green. I want to put in a little bit of a cold yellow. I want some brightness to this, but I don't want it to stand out like in your face. Maybe a little bit of this gamboge. Oh, that's a little better. Even that little bit, I can tell that's a bit better. Okay. let's see, Don, you're new on Discord, so you're learning your way around. I'm somewhat new on Discord. I don't spend as much time there maybe as I should. So we'll all learn together over there. And the good news is, if you ask a question pretty much anywhere on Discord, whether it's in my channel or not, if you ask a question, there are lots of people willing to help you out and help you get to where you need to be and learn how to use the system and whatnot. And really, I think by this time I have talked enough. Let's get to painting. So I've got this little bit of color I'm playing with here. Don, do I stream on Twitch too? Yes-ish. I always say I'm going to, and then I oftentimes end up doing other things, and it seems as though my Twitch streams are not nearly as regular as they should be. So I'll say yes, but it's kind of a conditional yes that I stream on Twitch. I need to do more on Twitch. It's just that it's life gets in the way of life. I don't seem to have nearly as much time as I used to. I'm trying to do more with my kids. I'm trying to do more with my family in general. I'm working longer hours really at work. Those are all just excuses. Really? That's all they are. The answer is yes-ish, kind of. Sometimes, not all that often, not as much as I should. But you know what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying. Okay, so what I was going to say is the color that I have here that I'm playing with is what I'm using as the base color for my mountain here, and it's basically a yellow ochre, and it's got a bit of neutral tint in it. And if I had my Holbein watercolor set here, if I were using my Holbein set, they would call this ochre gray or some such thing. Yellow, gray, yellow, yellow, gray, some such thing as that. It's just a really muted yellow ochre. I muted it down with neutral tint, which is has a purplish tint to it. Purple and yellow are opposites, so they mute themselves out a bit, and so you get this really kind of natural rock color, but it's not so bright, it's not so vivid that it's kind of out of control, right? It's just kind of a muted color. And now I'm going to go back in immediately with a little bit of green here, and I'm going to allow it to touch the edges. I'm going to allow it to mix with these other colors. I just hope it doesn't go up too far, but I want these colors to mix a little bit. All right, see over here, this might be a little bit too far for me, but I'm going to try to abstain from working the paint too much. I want the paint to do some of its own thing. And if it turns out being not exactly like our reference photo, I'm going to try to live with that. I'm going to try to live with that and let it do what it wants to do. And these colors aren't the most saturated colors here anyway, so we're probably going to be fine with that. And as we come down, I'm going to grab some more of this ochre color. Maybe I'll put a little bit of this burnt umber in here. And then these trees, this green, this tree line kind of is going to blend into some fields here, right? This time of year, if you were to come around here, we don't have much green here, but what we have is a lot of brown. The reason we don't have a lot of green here is because we don't have a lot of water here. It's always has seemed funny to me that I'm literally... My house is, where I'm sitting, is a half a mile from the Pacific Ocean, and I have no water. It's always seemed funny to me, but so be it. That's how it is. Now, I've got a little road here. I've got a little road here coming out of my barn, and I'm not going to paint into that. Paint right over my roof there, and I can come right down. I've got that. I strategically put this a little bush right here. You can hardly see it, but you'll see it in a minute. Put a little bush right there so that I could anchor that corner of this and not have to worry too much about having a hard edge there or something like that. Now I've got a distant hill back up here. I can just drop a little color in here. And it should be lighter than everything else. Something like that. And we're almost done with our whole first layer of this painting, which is to me a kind of astounding that we can paint a whole landscape painting. Not the whole landscape painting, but quite a bit of a landscape painting and be done with a great portion of it in such a short amount of time. They start out so quickly. All right, there we go. That's going to be my whole first layer on this painting. And I'm going to leave it like that. And so while I'm waiting for this layer to dry, and I can blow dry it off if we need to, I need to remember a couple of things. So in order to bring this house forward, or this barn forward, let me get a pointer here. In order to bring this forward, I need to do two things. I need to make all the colors here more intense, more saturated, and if I can, more red, and that will pull these forward. And then the other thing I need to do is I need to make sure that I hope when this dries, all this hill, this mountain, that it lightens up. I hope I didn't get it too dark. If I got it too dark, it's going to look a little funny, and it'll make this hill look smaller and closer to us. But if this lightens when it dries, then I can intensify some of the color up here, maybe the green up here, and then just leave it lighter before we get to the house, and that will give the illusion of some distance in there. If we need to really, we can come back and take some of this color off. I'm gonna hope I don't have to do that, but we could do that, and that would and then like stretch this painting out. Okay, so those are a couple things there. Jacqueline says, do you do various value sketches before you choose your subject? I haven't for this. I don't for a lot of them. I used to do a lot of value studies, and I'll tell you what I used to do. I used to divide the page in half. I would do four really quick sketches, so it would basically be a triangle with a little house in front of it, and then I would briefly go through and go, if this is really dark here and it's really dark here, is it going to look good? If it's really light here and it's really dark here, is it going to look better? If this, I would do this on the four different corners. I would test a few things out, right? How light does this have to be to make it look like it's back behind this? Or, what's the value difference there? Or I would do things that way. I don't know. I'm not the best person with value paintings before. You kind of get a good idea, but I always think, that's not exactly what I wanted. But, excuse me, I have a little pink lemonade in here. I went up to the store and went, what am I going to drink? What would be really fun that I haven't had in a long time? Oh, pink lemonade. I love pink lemonade. What was I going to say? I was going to say I like to work by the basic premise that things closer to you, darker and redder. Things further away from you, lighter and bluer, and just use that in general. And then, of course, you've got to monkey with that a little bit to tweak your values so you get them just the way you want them. But basically, that's how I do it at this point. Okay, I'm going to mix up a little bit of... Ooh, that was fizzy. Ooh. Wow. I'm going to mix up a little bit of our rock or rock-ish color here with a little bit of blue in it, and hopefully that's going to give us some nice shadowing back here. Nice shadow color, not too dark, not too light. Get maybe a little bit of extra water in there, and if we're just dry enough. Oh, I better give it another second before I do anything with it. What other questions do you have? You guys must have some more questions that I can answer. Sorry with the wording. I've been on little sleepy. Oh, because of my little. That's okay. I'm gonna get really goofy with my speech here in a little bit because I've been up so long. I know, there goes my Tang sponsorship. I know. I know, this is the first time in 2 months I haven't had Tang out here, and I thought about it. I've only got a little bit of Tang left, so I don't know. I do like Tang. Tang is good. My Tang sponsorship. All right, I'm going to forge ahead, and we'll throw caution to the wind here. And so we can look here, or you can look here, and I can, well, we, I guess you and I can look here. And we have a flat color of our rocks that go through here. There's a little bit of green spread among them at this point, and that's fine. This is the point where we're going to start giving them a little bit of life. And we can do that maybe with a smaller brush, slightly smaller brush. Let's try that. I'm going to drop down a size here. And with a little bit of hard edges on here, we're going to be able to define however we want these rocks to look. Right? I want this to look like this. A little bit of extra color on here. This comes down. I'm only putting this color on the rocks where I want them to be. Be able to define a little bit of, I got that a little too loose, but that's okay. Let's take a look at this rock over here. Everything from back here going to have a shadow on it, and over here. And now we're starting to get a little bit of, we should be starting to get a little bit of definition in these. Oh, your dog has a fractured paw. Oh, I didn't tell you guys 2 weeks ago, I almost had a dog. I almost got a, or maybe I did tell you. Did I tell you I almost got a dog? Well, Jacqueline, I hope your puppy's okay. I don't know how you would fracture a paw, but I can't imagine that it feels good. So I hope he's okay. See, we can really start to define what these look like. Get some color over here. Sounds like this. I always feel a little weird because I'm just looking down. I'm trying to concentrate. I don't always do well. I feel bad that I'm not paying attention and talking to everybody. Sometimes you gotta do it. Let's see. This whole thing is going to kind of be in shadow over here. This is low enough around our mountain, that's all in shadow there. Let's make this come down a little bit like that. There we go. Okay, and I'm just going to pull off a little bit of the excess. And with any luck, right, without doing too much more to it. Oh, actually, let me do this. I didn't see this here. We should be able to. Come on, give me a little bit more in there. This comes down there. And I'm going to send this across there like that. There we go. Now this should really give some definition to these rocks over here. It should start to look like we have something going on. And we do. We do. And while we're waiting for that to dry now, I'm going to jump over here and I'm going to wet the top of this, the barn, the roof here, top of the barn or the roof, whichever you would call it. I need to lean out a little bit to see what I'm doing. I should say I put in Discord and talk about it here. I'm happy to talk about it. Some of the things that I hope to accomplish this month, and I got most of them done, but one of the things that I've yet to do, I didn't put it down necessarily, but I'm going to try to get out to do it, is, well, this needs more red in there. This is going to be some rust on here. This is an old roof. It's kind of brown. It's got some, maybe it's got a little bit of blue in here. Get some of this cobalt blue in here. It's a steel roof here, but it's got some rusty spots on here. One of the things I was hoping to do, I took off work tomorrow in hopes of being able to do it, but now I'm not completely sure I'm going to be able to do it, is to get out to do some plein air painting. I mean, you can see, if this is what I'm looking at on my drive to work every day, I probably have a few spots I could go to that are pretty nice, right? Probably a few. And I do. So I was hoping to get out and do some of that tomorrow on a day off. But quite honestly, there we go. I don't know if you can see that. I just made some lines on that roof. You know, maybe there's, so those metal plates are put together and they're a little, they got a little bit of rust on them at this point and they're not perfect. So we're going to make it look old. But I was going to try to get out and do some plein air painting tomorrow. It's too foggy. I don't know if I can do it. I'm hoping I can. I've tried to paint in the fog before. Really hard. It's really hard. Your paint never dries. It's quite difficult to do, as it turns out. So, as a result, I don't know, I might be staying in and trying to edit some video. All right, so I've got some areas on my hillside here. We're going to put some darker colors up here. Hopefully, that pulls that back that way. Some greens in there, some blues in there, some shadows on the greens. And like I said, well, let's hope that pulls that up that way a little bit. We have to let that dry a little bit. I've got my roof. I like my roof here. This half of my barn is going to be in shadow, right? My sun is coming through here. I don't know, maybe this whole side, but I will put a little shadow underneath the side of the barn here, but I'm going to leave it kind of lighter, kind of a lighter color. But before I do too much, I want to mix up another green here to make some trees, the trees that are going to go right around here. And I'm going to make, I don't know, there're going to be some that are a little dark and, well, whatever. I'll put some color over here too. Some that are a little bit lighter. Right, I just want a couple of different values of greens here so that I can have just a little bit of, yeah, I can't go back here yet. I can't go back there yet. What can I do? I know what I can do. I can do this. I can take a little bit of neutral tint. And I'm going to go right up inside this door. Just a little line of neutral tint there. Almost pure, you know, right out of the tube, right off the tray. Neutral tint. And I'm going to start pulling that down a little bit. And I want to keep that wet, because I'm going to introduce some ultramarine to that. Not quite with that much water. I want a mix of colors inside this barn. And then as it comes out, I got too much water on there, I can tell. I want to put on, actually I should put on a little bit of sepia. Boy, everybody's quiet this evening. Quiet. Why is everybody so quiet? Excuse me, I've been talking all day. So by this time of the day, my throat gets so dry. Here's our little road that comes out. I'm going to put a little bit of Payne's Gray in that road too. Right? I've probably got about enough paint here to do about half of it. I'm going to pull it out. And my hope is that this kind of looks like a bit of a gravelly road here. We can add some texture to it if we need to. But it's just an old farm, you know, like a dirt pathway. Up there it goes right into that barn. And because I'm doing this wet and wet, that color should just take right up in there, and it'll look like it runs right into that barn. And maybe got a little bit too much blue in there, but that's okay. It looks good over here. So there's my pathway. I'm really banking on the fact here that the Payne's Gray, which is a bit dark when you put it on, is really going to lighten up, which it usually does. It usually lightens up quite a bit. It's 11:38 in Maine. Holy cow. That's late. I know it's late. I would love to do this earlier. I would love to do it at a different time. This is kind of the time I have made with my family that I've gotten the okay to do it at this time, because we have so much other stuff going on that I can say, well, this is the time I'm blocking out to do this, and nobody says you can't, and nobody's upset about it, because we all know. That's it. Live Accident, you're lying down as well, a long day. Live Accident, I hope you're feeling a lot better. Let's see, I'm mixing up some blue here. I just want to put a touch of, I'm mixing up some green. I just want to put a touch of blue in it. And I want to come back up. I'm going to try to avoid putting my hand in this wet paint here. But I want to up here and put some greens up here to try to, oh no. Okay, maybe it's not quite dry enough yet. Maybe I just had too much. No, don't go over there. This is one problem with the wood pulp paper. God, I couldn't think of it for a second. This is one problem with wood pulp paper is that it retains moisture really well, but it will allow that paint to flow wherever there's any moisture at. And if you have just a little too much, then it's pretty unforgiving. I could have just waited an extra 5 seconds or so, a minute, whatever it would have been, I don't know, to let it dry out a little bit more. It probably would have been totally fine. But that's not my way. I don't do it. I'm all right-ish. I got another wave of allergy. Oh, man. Oh. Allergies are no fun. Just really fun at all. I'm sorry that you're going through that. They're just not good to deal with. Okay, so look, here's some trees coming down. I don't know. I could give a little jagged edge on my skyline here, but I don't think I need to. I want this to be like it's pushed back, you know, a ways. In front of our, or right behind our house here. It's pushed back a ways, so I gotta try and mix something that's very similar to that color. It doesn't have to be the same, but similar to that. I guess I'm kind of close to it now. And I'm gonna put in some more of these tree-ish areas. It might be a little darker than that one. Let me drop a few extra drops in here. Not quite the same, huh? I think I don't have nearly as much yellow in this one. Let's get a little bit more yellow in here. That looks better. Looks better. Let's make these more the same. Anybody have any other questions? Well, if there's no other questions, that's all good. I like answering questions. I can't help it. Love answering questions. So I don't do a whole lot of landscapes, right? You know, you guys don't see me doing a whole lot of landscapes, but try to take a little inspiration from this. And there's a little place. I was going to say south of here, but I don't know. I don't know. Inland. Let me just say it that way. There's a little place inland from here called Edna Valley, and there's this little tiny I guess it was originally a general store in Edna Valley. It's now been turned into a touristy kind of a place, in a place where you would have a wedding and whatnot, you know. So I've covered with tourists. You can do wine tasting there, I believe. Yeah, that kind of stuff. And it's really a cute little place. I'm not saying anything bad about it, but I went online and I was like, well, maybe I should retouch some of this landscape. Watercolors were, you know, originally used to paint landscape. Actually, originally used by the military to paint battlefields and whatnot. But that's you know, landscapes nonetheless. And so I was like, well, let me see what I can do with this. And so I started painting it last night, and I think I've got this. This needs to be lightened a little bit through here, but that can continue to come down a little bit. And I'll tell you why that needs to be lightened in just a second. And now we've got a little ridge here that comes in front. We could paint something else on that or leave that the way it is. I think I'll add some color to this little mountain or this little hill right here. But maybe I'll do that after it's had a chance to dry for a moment. But now look, our hills are coming to life here, right? Look, now they're nestled in something here. Are you working with a certain color scheme in mind or just using your full palette? I'm using whatever comes to mind. I hate to say it. I'm mixing my colors based upon what I look at in the reference photo here and whether I want a warm color or whether I want a cold color. So to me, and that's a good question to ask. To me, the mountains, the rocks in these mountains are a warm color. If you can look at that, and it's probably pretty small for everybody, you can see there's some ochres and maybe some pinks in there, definitely some warm colors. So my thought was, let's get some warm colors in there. And then on the shadow side, I want to make sure I get shadow. So I'm going to use some colder colors over on the shadow side. Now my trees, right? All of this green around here, this is what I'm calling the trees. I just want to get a medium green out there. If there's some areas that are a little warmer and some areas that are a little colder, right? This area up here, to me, has a little bit more blue in it. It's a little cooler. This area in here obviously is a little bit warmer, has a little bit more yellow in it. I'm okay with that because this is natural variation. There's a little bit of color here and there. It's kind of a cheat. I'm not trying to use like, you know, only four colors and have the whole palette be so tight as to only use those. I'm kind of just going by feel on it. If that helps, if that answers your question, I hope it answers your question. I'm not really looking for a specific color scheme on here. Actually, what I should do here is I should add a little bit of blue into here. I had that Payne's gray in there, but let's knock this color down a little bit. This is a kind of a shadowy side to this. This is a little tricky because it's a, in my mind, and we have a couple of these red barns out here. This is a red color, and you can go with a more of a purpley color, or you can try to darken the red. You can put a little bit of brown in it. The darkening red is like darkening yellow. It's a little tricky. You can go a number of different ways with it. I think in this instance, a little bit of blue and a little bit of Payne's gray that's in there is probably pretty good. What we want, or for what we need, and I'm actually going to add a little bit more blue to this as I add a shadow just underneath here. And hopefully that'll set that roof line off. Maybe we should take it all the way to the end there. Hopefully that'll set that roof line off just a little bit. There we go. Does that look like it sets it? It does look like it sets it off just that little bit, doesn't it? Just trying to understand my approach. Good luck, Jacqueline. Good luck. No. That's what I'm doing. I'm not looking for a specific color or a specific color palette. I'm looking at more warms and colds and how I want to gauge the feel of this. As I'm looking at that reference photo, it looks to me as though it's taken a little bit later in the fall, that the picture was taken a little bit later in the fall. There are in this section of the reference photo, you can see there's a series of buildings and some trees, and the trees are really brown. Like some of them look like they have no leaves on them at all, right? So it looks as though it's a little later in the year. If I add a little bit more yellow, warm this up just a little bit, I mean, not make it like super warm or anything, then it'll look like it's more, a little bit more in the summer or late spring anyways. And I think this has a summery feel to it, much more than the reference photo does. I don't know that helps you out a ton, but it should help you out a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna do this. You ready? Let's do this. I'm gonna paint a tree here, and I probably shouldn't be doing this. this is not the time. I should have painted this little crest of a hill here first before I painted this tree, but that's okay. It's totally fine. So this little tree, you can see I'm flicking my brush around. I'm not trying to get an edge. I don't even know what this edge is, but I want to get a, there's a tree I know that lives behind this barn here. Now I sound like Bob Ross. There's a little tree that lives back here, and I'm just going to give him a little bit of life. And I'm actually going to drop in. Where can I get a little bit of extra color at? Give me this blue and this green. Let's see how this looks together. I don't want too much moisture in it, though. There we go. And while I've got a wet bit of paint here, I'm going to drop in a little bit of this extra dark color here. And that's going to give all the shadowing. Let's see, you can see it right there, to that tree right off the top. And I'm also going to do the same thing over here. Let me mix a little bit more of this color. Let's go with this. We'll change our tree color just ever so slightly. I'm afraid that it's gonna match this too much. So I may end up making an early night. Oh no. Okay. Well, lab accident. Feel better. I hope. I don't wish allergies or being sick or anything like that on anybody. That's just not a lot of fun. So you have a great night. Take care of yourself and feel better. And when you're back and ready to watch another video, well, I'll be back here on another Wednesday and we'll make another video. There we go. We're getting this. And there just happens to be a tree around this side too. You know what? I want to make sure you can tell the difference here. And then as I come down here, it's going to get really dark. The shadow side of the barn over here. So really dark over there for this tree. Well, that's going to go out like that. Something like that. Okay, so there's a tree right there. All of a sudden, right? This is easy as that. Actually, this is kind of one of the things I do like about landscapes. Is I didn't do anything. But all of a sudden, by putting these two trees on there, we've made a separation between what's in the background and what's in the foreground. And we just pulled this whole barn right towards us. I mean, dramatically towards us. Right, now I told you there was a shrub over here too. I'm going to drop it in here. And the reason you put this one in is because you don't want to paint the corner of this. I don't know what's back there. I don't want to know what's back there around that corner. I don't even want to give anybody the ability to go back around there. So I drop in this little shrub here. Give a little bit of dark. Actually, that's still a little too damp over there. We'll drop in a little bit of this dark on this side of it. Again, the light's coming from this way. And this one too, we can make this one go as far as we want to. This one in front. Maybe this one comes all the way up like this. I know you spent all this time painting. We did the corner of this. I put the shadow in just so, and now I'm painting right over it. Like, why would I do that? Well, you know, you do because corners aren't always the most interesting thing to paint. And you know, that anchors. You get something in the corners of this, it really helps to anchor this painting quite a bit. So, I don't know, that's probably what that one looks like. I need some dark. Just give me, this is my olive green, but it's a wonderful color. I don't know if I'd eat an olive that was that color, but it does a great job for some other things. I need to get a brush that I can paint a line with. I don't know. Here we go. This little tiny one. Here, this guy's got a little stem down here or something like that. And we're gonna give this guy a shadow out in front there. So everything's gonna go over this way a little bit. And that'll give some definition to the stuff in the front here. So any other questions about anything? Anybody? I'm losing a few viewers. Which is fine. People have to go and do things. I get it, but I always feel like if I keep people talking, they'll stay and visit with me. Let's see. This is a bit of a, I don't know. What am I going to do here? I'm going to add a little bit up here on this. Just slightly. And then I'm going to blend this color way down here, way down to where we're at. I don't want this to be one solid color. That's bothering me just a little bit. So I'm going to grab that and pull that up. Thirsty, are you still here? We haven't heard a joke this week. You got any good jokes that you could throw out there? Could all use a good laugh. There we go. So we've got a little extra color on there. See, I'll probably do the same thing over here a little bit. Just a little extra color as it comes down here. Make sure that goes all the way to the edges. And lightens as it comes to us. All right, let's see. Let's mix a little blue gray here, a little blue gray, a little shadow color. I've got all of these colors here on my palette. I'll just put all of those into one. Probably going to be a decent shadow color. I'm never good with shadows anyways. But I'm going to try on this one to see what we can do. Maybe there's a little shadow from this on the side of this building over there. There, something like that. Look, that's on that building a little bit. Shadow for this guy. He's not too close to that building, but he's there a little bit. Comes across. This guy must throw a big shadow here. Well, the barn has to throw a shadow. So let's get some shadow from the barn in there. And then this big old tree must throw a bit of a shadow. Something like that. There it is. There's a shadow from that going out there. Now, I do have some fencing to put in over here. And while I'm waiting for all of this to dry in the foreground, I'm going to come back into the background. Maybe I should stay with a little bit smaller brush. And I'm going to grab a little bit of this color and just add a little bit more blue to this. And I'm going to come in here and define maybe a few more cracks and crevices in our rocks. Not too many, but just a few here and there. I really want to make this, I want to gift to it the look of some cragginess. So we need to put that in. And we don't have to do it with any specific lines or anything like that, but we do need to have a few in here. Right, if this rock has some big cracks and crevices in it, if it's got a few really big holes in there, as it was forming, right? As this rock was forming, now that it got all of these nooks and crannies in there, we need to give it a lot of these so we can see that, so the viewer can take that away and go, oh, I get it. And I have to turn this upside down for a second. And I have to try to remember the way that this rock is formed, and it kind of comes up this way. I'm only doing it upside down so that I don't put my hand in that. This I would normally do right side up. But you can see when I turn it right side up, now all of a sudden those cracks and crevices, that little cragginess that's in there, start to give it a little extra life. Right, to give it some of that coolness that these old rocks have. And I'm not being specific about any of it. I'm just letting the brush kind of bounce off the page and kind of go wherever it wants to go. Just trying to do it with a light touch. And trying to give it a little bit of intent so that we can see some of that cragginess. All right, you're all are really making me nervous now because it feels like it's been like 15 minutes and nobody said anything but me. And that can never be a good thing. You have to listen to me ramble on for 15 minutes. Oh, holy cow. Something has gone wrong. Something has really gone wrong. All right, I don't know that I'm going to do too much more. I don't want to put so much detail back there that you take your eye off of everything up here. But what I do want to do is I'm going to put a line here, and I want to intensify the door color here a little bit. I don't know that that's the right color. Let's just make this door a little bit different color. Maybe it should have been white. Maybe it should have been something else. I don't know, but we need to set this door off just a little bit from the rest of everything. There we go. There's our door. Right down to there. Now maybe it can slide back and forth. Afraid to bring anything up. You're afraid to bring anything up? No. That's the wrong. I don't want you to be afraid to bring anything up. I want this to be a safe place. You can bring anything up that you want. I love the questions. I want questions. And while you're thinking of the next question that you're going to ask, seriously, please don't be afraid to ask. And you can ask whatever you want. And simply, I'll just say, if I don't want to answer it, or if I can't answer it, I'll just tell you I can't answer it. But when I answer just about everything that I can, I'm looking at this. Okay, so now I want to put in a bit of a fence, right? I've got my hills back here. I've got my barn in the front. What I need to do is put in a couple of fence posts here. Oop, and then this one needs to be a bit smaller. It's a bit further back there. If we can even see it, maybe we can. Maybe we can't see this one. Oh, maybe I have. Maybe I don't have enough on this. Let's load up a little extra color on here. There we go. There's it. And then one way back there, by the barn. If we just make these a little bigger, each one a little bit bigger, then it gives the appearance of coming towards us. And I like that. I want it to look like it's coming towards us. Now we got some cross beams on here. Let's see if we can do this. Yeah, I guess I'll make these. I was thinking maybe I'll make these like barbed wire or something, but now we'll make it like a split rail fence. Why not? I do this, and then I really do feel like Bob Ross. I hear crickets. You hear crickets? Not at my house. I'm not sure. I think we got a lot of spiders this year. I think the spiders may have gotten all the crickets at my house. Yeah, okay. I'm kind of happy with the way this is turning out. I love the barn over here. It doesn't look like it's set a mile in front of the hill in the back, but you do get the sense of some bigness back there. And I'm stalling to try to figure out how I can put a shadow on my fence here. I don't have any idea on how to do that. I have no clue. I'm going to do this. I'm going to take some of our yellow ochre and I'm going to mix it with, I'll mix it with a little bit of, alizarin crimson, right? And I'm going to try to make this, our front, even a little closer to us. So let's see if I can do, that and just, just put on a little bit of extra color here, there, something like that. Anything with a little bit of a red tint to it is going to bring this whole bottom portion right up to us. And then if I really wanted to, I could take and just drop in a few grasses right around some of these. Maybe a few on here, right around our road. Right? Boop, 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 boop. A few little, that's going to be too much water. A few little things in front of our farm here. A few little lines here and there. It's something growing here. I don't know what it is. It's something growing. A few little odds and ends here and there. That's going to give it a little extra interest in there. And I think for what I'm going to do, I think that's going to be it for me for tonight. Trying to look to see where I have a pen to sign it. And I must have moved it off my desk. So that's what I have for you this evening. I hope you like this little barn, this made-up little barn. It's not a real barn, but it's made-up little barn sitting in front of this beautiful mountain, Hollister Peak. Maybe a warm summer's evening has come, and this is what we see. Some goods and some bads. I kind of wish I had gotten this a little bluer in some places. The rocks back here, just a little bluer. Maybe the shadow area is a little bit darker in some places. If I were going to do this again and spend 3 or 4 hours on this, I would probably put another layer of dark on these hills back here to really make that shadow a bit more dramatic. I love the barn. I guess I would probably, if I were going to do it, I would take this 18-0 liner, and I'd probably draw a couple of lines on the barn, maybe a couple of lines on the roof to show where a couple of the boards are and a couple of the panels on the roof are. Yeah, I don't know if it's necessary, but I might do that. I love the trees, you know, saying some of the things I do. I love the trees back here. The trees around the corner of this barn really set it off. They really plant it in place and set it off from the rest of the painting that's behind it. So I really like that. And I do like the fence is quick and easy to make. There's not anything really dramatic about it. It's a flat brush that I've tapped on there, boop, 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 you know, both ways, but it's kind of a cute little feature that could have been on there, or, you know, brings the whole thing together. It stretches the farmhouse or the barn across the painting this way and connects the left side and the right side to it. So that's all I've got for you guys this evening. I want to thank you all for joining me. Jacqueline, Lab, Accident, who else is here? Dawn, Thirsty, whoever else is here. Thank you all so much for joining me. I had a great time painting this. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me. I hope to be back with you next Wednesday at 8 Pacific when we'll paint something else. I don't know. Don't know what it is. I haven't made up my mind yet, but it'll be something fun and interesting. Fingers crossed. links down to everything that you would need down below. Website, social media. I don't know, whatever else is down there. Anyways, that's what I've got for you guys tonight. Thank you so much. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.